Kings and prime ministers were at the field when Wilbur demonstrated the plane near Paris. He won medals and prizes. Almost simultaneously, after Teddy Roosevelt intervened, a demonstration was made for the United States Army. If the plane flew 10 miles and met other qualifications, the Army would buy it for $25,000. Only a few Americans had ever seen an airplane when Orville Wright started the engine. Some eminent scientists still claimed human flight was impossible. Accompanied by an Army officer, Orville took the pilot's seat. For the Army, it was the beginning of a great Air Force. For the Wright brothers, it was recognition after years of ridicule and scorn. For the onlookers, some of whom wept with emotion, it was a breathtaking miracle. A year later, the Wright Airplane Company was formed. Soon new names were added to the roster of American airmen. Glenn Curtiss gave the world its first hydroplane. In France, Louis Bleriot, a friend and admirer of the Wrights, prepared for a flight across